All right, I'm going to continue with the discussion about the gods. Today I'm in a massive rush to go out there on the internet and make what do you call them, username claims, claim my username again and again and again. So I made the new sites, sort of. But yet I really wanted to just get out there and on the chat room and sweep the floor a little bit. And I'm not allowed to do this because I didn't have the right setup for my Adobe thing. So I'm not going to show the sweeping today on the film, on the camera. So that is a miss. So I'm just wondering, this particular deity, it is an expression of hurry and get out there and network. This is that type of a wake up morning. Some kind of energy in that direction. So yeah, go through your regular regimen of, you know, what you eat, what you drink or partake of, and then onto your exercise, and then so it is this, it's almost like a regimental yet one that is completely involved in technology as a does not want it to stop. So it's an interesting channel. However, in I call it the crud of this moment, I'm like, well, why didn't I just sweep it, you know? Why didn't I just sweep it before I made this video? But it doesn't work that way sometimes. Life doesn't always work that way. So it is yet again another hurried god. So we have all these hurried gods, you know. What's going on with the hurry? And I know this, and I'm thinking, okay, I've made these username claims to the, what is it, the vloggerhead, there it is, yeah, and the tinychat there with, oh my gosh, bosoms there, and well, wow, what can I say, congratulations for her. However, we have to always think of run back and remember that oftentimes those are already occupied with contraceptives in growth and other things such as the estrogen cow milk. She may be drinking also cow milk that has made them estrogen large, too heavy, which is a danger actually to her health. So when you're looking at them over large like this, if they've not been silicone put in also, it is, you're starting to look at, oh my gosh, you're almost an unhealthy bosom, as beautiful as it is in its, you know, bounty. It does have a attached to it. You know, it comes with you know, it can't even just be a bosom enjoyed any longer. It has other possibles that have brought it to the sizes of that particular. And then yes, there is the pregnant woman who is engorged in this fatal bosom also. So you have either A, she's pregnant, or which used to be the old easy way in seeing it, but no. There are many other disguises of the bosom now, and so we're looking at the estrogen in the, sorry, the lighting. I thought I had the lighting right, but I don't. The estrogen in the cows. She's drinking the steroidal. I call it the steroidal hormone milk. Yeah, because they are producing how many sizes more in their udders, you know, extra large in their udders, and then you drink and partake of this milk, you end up also extra large in your udders. It flows out, and so it becomes a dishealth of a person. There was the one and that way, and then yeah, the beautiful original was the enjoyment of the man and woman and in that particular birth experience, but no, that doesn't go on to be that only. We have science that has preoccupied there, and so then we have the contraceptives. The contraceptives are some trick, aren't they? The contraceptives are some trick. Wow. Wow. So what is it? You only need 1 or 2 weeks, and it's ta-da. Is that it? Yeah. A woman is made. A woman is made in 1 and 2 weeks. Is that a woman now? Is that a woman because she has contraceptive bosoms? Oh, my gosh. My gosh. What is the other reason? I don't know. I think that there's plenty already, but it looks awfully like a heavy query, a heavy question into too many of those pamphlets with the little lines and the little disclaimers. You know, does she come with a disclaimer? You know, I don't know. I can't enjoy it. You know, I can't enjoy it. You know, even as a spectator. So, the other one was the silicone. The silicone, just put them in there forever. And yeah, well, that's the other problem. So, anyway, I'm very excited. I have my new accounts. And no, I didn't get to get up and sweep and do that. But yeah, that's the whole point of it, isn't it? Is to play in those rooms sometimes and just be there. Oh my goodness, I think I got a phone call again. They're going to turn off the electric. And then they said, if you want it back, you call us on the telephone or something. So I don't know. I think I have a husband out there. Anybody knock on his door and tell him to pay my electric? That would be wonderful. Yeah. That would be really great. Oh my gosh. So, what else am I talking of? Well, the deities. Each day has got this deity going on, doesn't it? And I was speaking. I made a really, really, really long video of the deity of. Oh my goodness, the deity of. I had to get out of it. I made that stupid black screen on the giddy, and I'll try to put some image over on top of it, but. I made the video, but it was awful because I had the blanket here, and the blanket was just being ridiculous, and so I could not keep my face even in actress form of what Giddy is, because Giddy is a little bit of an actress, isn't she? Yeah, so it was a shame actually, because it wasn't that awful, but yeah, I had a terrible blanket. Yeah, so oh. Oh yeah, these making of the videos. Oh my gosh. So what else? Oh yes. I was talking of the elephant spirit god, the original painters, and how it happened, somebody did give the paintbrush to the very long time ago in Alaska, where they started this with the painting of the making the elephants paint. It could have been started before this, but for some reason the zoo began it, and yet that particular animal, that particular elephant, was not the greatest painter. Did paint spots, did paint shapes and forms, but it's not a great painter, and later on there are ones in India now, and they are painting miracles, some of them, and it's like, how is this possible? They're almost better than the humans, you know, better than the humans in the painting. So when we have this what do we call it, that kind of that animal spirit that is able, that is in touch with it's just easy, it just flows off like a god, like it is an elephant god that can paint. I mean, admit it, there are animals that have their attunements also to be gods, and my gosh, that is incredible to me. Yes. I cannot say that this cat over here that's slurping at herself is a god. I cannot say so, but she definitely wants the requirements listed after her, that she is a goddess. And I know it's so easy to say, oh my gosh, my dog is a god, my cat, my hamster. I want all of these animals to be gods, don't we? Don't we? Yes, we want them, but I guess with this, whether we are on the deity, one deity, a day only allowed per species, and that means the humans, and that means one new deity only. So it does put a limit on them. So it's kind of exciting to not have so many, because in a way it does make it's not a leadership role necessarily. It's not like you have to be the leadership role of the world. Like I get a little cranky with sometimes. It's not anything like this. How can I say it? It's a miraculous energy that is a guider for the others, and when we talk about the guider for the others, okay, well, if the guider for the others are the animals also, why cannot they be channeling with me as the human? And so we have all of these. Oh my gosh, that's amazing. You say, no, you can't have the channel with the humans. Don't talk of this. We want to talk serious and get into what is it we want to talk about. We want to talk about displacement. I wanted to talk about rocks and displacement. Oh my gosh, rocks and displacement. Yeah, I had a major thoughts last night. I'm thinking about the energy of displacement and attraction. So when we have the energy of attraction and the energy of displacement, right then and there is a life form. Okay, so I won't say straight up life form, but we want to go back to, what do we want to talk about? We want to talk about the molecule, the replicating molecule. We want to talk about the propagating molecule. Well, yeah, when you're getting into the molecular level, you have to respect the rocks also, because there are the molecules there. So right there, they are, you can look at the flower. If you can't handle the rocks right now, look at the flower. It is making its decisions. It's making its decisions, isn't it? It's a populator. It is a survival populator making decision. And in making that decision of its domesticity, in its degreed design, it's decided upon a particular design that it likes. Now, how the design is gone into, you know, you could say the daisy. How does this daisy go into the design, and become for sure, this is it. You know, I've put myself into the daisy design. If you look at one molecule that has the agreement of survival, regardless, it has a displacement energy and it has attraction energy. And so when you have the other molecules around displacing an attraction into and out of, you're going to have changes. And in the survival moment of the into and the out of, and those changes going on, you're going to have an evaluated going, well, this is surviving, I am surviving this particular way. And so when you're surviving in this particular way, you're going to continue it. So, and you're going to replicate that continuance. And If I say replicate, we can say replicate as a clonic self. Yes, it's a clonic endurance that continues and continues and continues and has to continue, because that has been what has gone on as a work, hasn't it? Has gone on as a work and success. Now, at some point in time, those works and success do have new inclusions. They have new inclusions. They have new absolute. I won't say absolute, no. They have new attractions that for some reason, either they cannot stir away from, they cannot stir away from those attractions. And yet, so they continue in survival and blossom with. And so there it is, there is this flower, a small daisy that grows and blossoms with. And yet over there, we have new inclusions of, yes, this is working, and this is working, and this is working, and this is flower state, and this is flower state, and this is another flower state. And then we have a new inclusion. We have a new inclusion grouping of elementals, and those elementals are working also with it. And there it is, there's a change. And so there's, what do we call this? We want to call this Darwinism, I guess. It is, we'll call it Darwinism all the way back to the rocks, the stones, the flowers, the plants, all the animals. Sure, you can call it from there. But, so it begins, I can push it back to the bacteria state. We'll love the bacteria, don't we? Get back to the bacteria scrunge. The bacteria scrunge of... What is a bacteria scrunge of? Bacteria scrunge of entering good heavens, what are they doing there on the soapy seas that are not soap? They are simply bubbled over froth bacteria. And the bubbled over froth bacteria zipping in and creating life right there. They like to start this place. That is a funny spot, to start it there, because I believe it started way before there. I believe it started way before. It started with displacement and attraction. When you have one particular set of grouping of molecules and atoms, and they're comfortable with each other, they're like, oh yes, I like myself. So we almost have a mirror state, you can see certain rocks going, I like myself. And so in another grouping of I will try to definitely keep my same organative and attach it to it. So you have what, the tanzanite, and the tanzanite gets bigger and bigger and bigger because it is attracted to itself. All right. So I use the tanzanite. Yeah, it's a pretty one, huh? Yeah. Ah. That was all. Oh my gosh. What am I doing here? That lighting maybe is better, not so bright and harsh. Ah. Yo. I'm getting excited with life again. I don't understand what's going on. Some days I'm not, but yeah, so getting into the bubbly froth, that's another place. It seems like a, wait a minute, there were other things way before bubbly and froth. I just don't go with it, You know, you have to go back to the attraction and the disattractions. So what do we have? You can even look at colors, your own self in your eyes. You can look at colors and you go, okay, would you ever put the hot pink together with the hot green? And for some persons they will, and that is very odd and very unusual. And others are like, no, it's too harsh. I do not want a hot pink and a hot green in a room together. It is my decor. That for me would be an ingrain. Just like a tentomatic state, and we don't want that going on. So already, there is that what do we call it? When things are put in that disagreeable right away. So So it's, this is the same as what the Tanzanite would be doing, or some crystal rock grouping. It's just attracted to certain. This is what I eat. This is what I feed. This is what is working. This is my survive. And I like to grow. I like to grow and become a beautiful crystal. And I will get become larger and larger and larger, and massive crystal, and inside some cave somewhere. And that is the way it's going with the rock formation. So, and the same goes. And then it's the need for survive, and it's the need for survive right there, and it is replicating itself. This works. This particular grouping. Hey, we make this rock milk quartz. Even we make a simple milk quartz, and that's a work. You know what I'm saying? Ah, I'm sorry, not lighting. I know you're supposed to be a professional by now. You're making the videos out on the internet so long and many. No, I'm not professional. I'm sorry. Oh. I don't know, it's dark. But yeah, so I'm dealing with rock groupings. You want to see the hair? There it is. It's orangish. So rock groupings. So there we are. We even with the attraction of self, woman. Man to woman. Oh my gosh, what would be my attraction to that kind of color ever? So, you know, some persons are like, oh gosh, not a redhead. Oh, not a redhead woman, get her out of here. And the others are like, oh, I can't stand it. I'm too attracted. I can't stop. You know, I can't stop. What is it? You know. Why? Back to that. It is just almost like this particular metal attraction. God dang it. I'll put it back to there, I guess. So. Oh. Anyway, yeah. What is this? My €3 clip-on lamp. It's Oh, it melted. It was a melt. I forgot. I wanted to show you all. It did melt. I have, see the clip on it? It is on a melt. It's on a melt angle, right here. So I don't know. Purchased it this way, and it was a melted clip. I don't know. I feel like making. What do you want? Disagreeable video. I'm supposed to stand out here like some freaking porcelain doll. Hello, everyone. Everything is wonderful. I'm not doing it. I'm not doing your stupid porcelain doll act, all right? All right, so what happens? I guess so. I'll be the dejected. I'll be the dejected group of mineral crystallizations, just because I'm not giving your porcelain doll act. I don't know. It gets tiring sometimes. It gets tiring. And I'm like, well, okay, I'll try it. I'll frump in like the others. So yeah, what was I talking? I'm talking this replicating molecule. And when my big worry right now is when it begins to replicate, when it actually begins to replicate and switch from replication, you know, that this is working. So I'm just in a clonic state. This is the rock group that is my little mix with, you know. When does it actually go into its life form state of is it that it has to modify? Is it that it has to modify out of replication? If it has to modify out of replication, to create not the tanzanite, but to create the oh my gosh, go into a tourmaline or an azurite or something. If it has to modify away from its prior replication at that particular time, when it is going away from its replication and modifying, that is a life move moment. That is a life move moment. Just like if you have to change a house or something, you have to move from one house to another. That is a life moment. So, adaptation to the regular strict, if there is a planet with daisies only, a planet that only has daisies. So after a while with this daisy planet, well, let's say there is something that happens in one area, microclimate of it, one thing that happens, and there is perhaps not the right sources of food, and they have to all of a sudden gather from another energy, another type of a stone that they weren't used to before. And so they have to use that stone, and that stone turns them another color. And they're like, oh my gosh, now we are the purple daisies, don't tell the yellows. All of a sudden, we are the purple daisies. We have modified right then and there. So the replicating molecule of those yellow daisies, dun 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 dun, dun, there is now the purple ones. And so we're like, oh gosh, there's life forms everywhere, just creating and creating, and just, we don't understand anything any longer. But originally, there it is, it began with this replicating molecule that works, and yet it's still in there in the purple daisy. The purple daisy is now, well, this is a survival habit now. I survive, I'm purple daisy, and I need and require these things. Now you take away my luxuries of my survival at all, I have to modify even there in the need state. I have to modify at that location, at that particular situation. I have to modify. So, and then on goes to the blues. You know, you have the blue flower, and then on goes to the fat petals and the fat, leaves, and everything is changing. So yeah, so now we have that. So I guess that's all I wanted to talk about. I'm really, really thinking about how it all is going on in the beginning.